Hello dear friends, let's continue our game making series from where we left off. In the previous video, we learned how to add light and shadow to our scene. In this video, we're gonna learn how to make a moving platform. Maybe you made a moving platform before. If your character didn't move smooth on the platform, you will learn the solution in this video. Let's start. Before I start the main topic, I wanna show you how to fix it if your shadow is rough like this. Switch to the game panel to see change. Open URP renderer and increase render scale. As you can see, it has become smoother. If you wanna soften it even more, open URP as well and increase render scale. Looks better. Okay, let's back to the main topic. First, I will make a sample scene for this video. I'm making sample scenes only to explain the related topic. After preparing all the elements that we're gonna use in the game, we're gonna make permanent game levels together. I disabled the camera controller script to keep the camera stable. Sample scene ready. I'll use the wall image for the platform. I dragged it onto the scene. I'll call it the platform. I wanna temporarily disable the background image to work comfortably. I'll activate the snapping tool for easy alignment. I move it by holding the control key for more small step. I wanna extend the platform a little. And of course, I'll add box collider to the platform. Let's move the platform. I will show the classical method first. We will see the errors of the classical method. And then we will create an advanced platform movement system. I will create two points named post A and post B. I want the platform to move between these two points. Select the platform and add moving platform script. Open the script. I wrote the necessary variables. I will move the platform with method moveTwards for now. When the player gets close enough to point A, its new target will be point B. And when the player gets close enough to point B, its new target will be point A. I set point B as starting target. Save this script and back to Unity. I drag and drop positions into their slots. And I set speed of the platform to 2. Start the game. The platform moves as we want. Let's jump on it. As you can see, the player cannot stand on the platform. Let's solve this problem. Open the script. When the player touches the platform, it will become the child of the platform and move with the platform. When the player's contact with the platform ends, the player will become free. Back to Unity. I will add another collider to the platform to detect contact with the player. I wanna check the contact only in this area. That's, the player will only move with the platform when it's on the platform, not when it touches its side or bottom. I will enable the East Trigger feature of the collider I just added. I wanna enable the background image. And I'll add a shadow caster to the platform. Start the game and test it. As you can see, the player can stand on the platform. But we have a new problem. The player doesn't move smoothly on the platform. What While the player is on the platform, it moves by freezing and shaking. Have you encountered this problem before? Please write in the comments. We will solve this problem with a simple physics law. I will completely change the movement system of the platform. We will make an advanced moving platform system. Open movement controller script. I added two new variables. IsOn platform variable will be true when the player is on the platform. Platform RB will represent the rigid body of the platform the player is touching. If the player is on the platform, I will add the velocity of the platform to the player. Open moving platform. I added new variables for new moving system. I will move the platform with velocity now. I created a function called direction calculate to determine the direction of the platform. The direction will be recalculated when the platform reaches the target point and the game starts. And of course, I will erase the old method moving the platform. Save and back to Unity. Select platform and add rigid body component. Change body type to kinematic. Start the game. The platform moves by a little freezing. Let's smooth the movement. Change the interpolate to interpolate. Looks better. Nice. The player moves smoothly on the platform. I changed the target points to move the platform in vertical direction. We have a new problem. The player leaves the platform. Let's see how to solve this problem. We can easily solve this problem by changing the gravity scale of the player. Let's the scale decrease first and see the change. Now, let's set the scale to 10. As you can see, the player no longer leaves the platform. Open the moving platform script. I'll add a variable named playerRB. I will increase the player's gravity scale as soon as the player is on the platform. I will restore the player's gravity scale as soon as the player leaves the platform. Save the script and back to Unity. Start the game. Okay, we solved this problem too. Let's make the platform a little more advanced. I will add more than two target points. I'll add an empty object to the moving platform named Weights to keep the target points. I will automatically add the target points to the array named waypoints. Update start method like this. When the platform reaches the target point, I will call the function named nextPoint. So I'll create a new method named nextPoint. When the nextPoint method is called, point index will increase or decrease, then the target point will change and the direction will be recalculated. We can erase the variable named postA and postB. Back to Unity. I will drag and drop weights to the slot. Nice, the algorithm is work. Let's improve the platform a little more. I will add weight duration to target points. Move direction will be 0 when next point is called, so that the platform doesn't move. Coroutine named wait next point will be started. After waiting time expires, move direction will be recalculated and platform will move. Start the game. As you can see, the platform is waiting when it reaches the target points. You can add as many target points as you want to the platform. I wanna create a prefab from the moving platform. Drag and drop the moving platform to the project panel. The prefab auto moving platform is ready. We can drag it to the scene we want and use it. In this video, we made a moving platform. We will start to design the levels when we also make other elements necessary for the game. I hope the video was helpful for you. I read all your comments. Your nice comments make me really happy and motivated. For more videos, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.